So CBD oil has been such a hot topic lately.
Many people are saying it's helping them with a variety of ailments. Joining us now to talk more about it is Alix Boyle from Connecticut Voice and Seasons Magazine.
And Kayla Tyska, a Shoreline yoga instructor who is now hosting pop-up CBD events. Welcome to both of you.
Thank you.
So first of all, what is CBD oil?
CBD oil is derived from the hemp plant, and it has some health benefits, but it does not have the THC that you would find in marijuana. So in Connecticut, it's legal. CBD oil is sold everywhere. It's sold at Bed Bath & Beyond. It's sold at gas stations. I bought some in a shoe store. Everyone seems to be using it for everything. The benefits are reduced anxiety, reduced pain. People are loving it.
People are loving it, and yeah. It's not harmful.
No, it's not harmful.
I'm just afraid I'm going to get high every time I hear this.
No, you will not get high because in Connecticut, it can only have trace amounts of THC, 0.03.
Okay.
So you will not get high from it.
But you bring up a good point because I know that you're hosting these events. You have to have good CBD oil. I know there have been studies where people go buy it, say, at the gas station and then at the real place, big difference in price. And they find out one has barely any CBD in it and it's fillers and it may not be good for you because it's not regulated by the FDA.
Yes. Absolutely. As a consumer, you really need to demand where you know where the hemp is being sourced. You need to know where the product is coming from. So again, we do have farms in Connecticut that are growing. The company I represent, we get our hemp from Europe. There's no pesticides. It's completely organic. The hemp plant is a bioaccumulator. It absorbs anything in the soil around it. So if there's metals, any contaminants, pesticides, herbicides, it's going to absorb into the plant. And then if you absorb the plant through the CBD, then you're consuming all of those harsh toxins. So you need to demand where you know where this hemp is coming from.
How do I take it? And it comes in different varieties?
Yeah,
and
we have a whole
forms?
Bunch of different yeah. forms. We have it for humans. We have it for pets. Pets actually
too.
Have more
yes.
endocannabinoid receptors in the body.
That's kinda
so
cool.
Yeah, it's
yeah.
really
they
cool.
Say, like, it helps if your cat has anxiety, your dog has anxiety. They have, like, in your article, someone had used it for a pet.
Yes.
And their dog was
15,
getting older.
A 15-year-old border collie that could barely walk. Mm. She started giving the dog CBD, and he actually had a better quality of life and better mobility. He was
aww.
Moving around better.
How long would we take it before we see a difference, and how much? I mean, I know one
yeah.
of the popular
mm-hmm.
ways are the droppers. That's the kind that I'm most familiar with.
Absolutely. So we recommend taking 50 milligrams internally to activate the endocannabinoid system. So all of us, we all have a system in our body where when we take the CBD, it attaches to receptor sites that promote homeostasis, that promotes the overall wellness in our body. We say 50 milligrams a day is what you need to activate that system. And the cool thing about CBD is that over time, you need to take less of it. So once you start taking it, it activates. It's a natural response in the body. But over time, we as humans, we stop taking hemp in our diet, so we stop getting the CBD and the hemp benefits. So we just need to take more to activate it, and 50 milligrams a day, and then you can wean yourself off if you need to.
Because
then the body will naturally produce it.
Wow, that's incredible. Well,
it
thank you so
amazing.
Much for being with us.
Yeah, thank you.
So,
all right. There's a lot more information that you can actually go and find out much more in the article on ctvoice.com, as well as Connecticut Voice Out Loud. That's their new TV show.
We appreciate you being with us.
Okay.
Happy
thank you for having us.
Happy hemp.